Let's discuss working and application of a Pitot tube. Pitot tube is an apparatus which utilizes the Bernoulli's theorem for the mathematical analysis to measure flow velocity of a fluid. For Pitot tube, you can also write it is a device used to measure flow velocity of a fluid. In this situation, let's have a look on the picture of a typical Pitot tube. Here you can see that this U-tube, which is termed as Pitot tube, this Pitot tube, which is connected to a pipeline in which a fluid is flowing. Say, let us consider a gaseous media is flowing with the velocity Vg. And in this Pitot tube, there is an immiscible liquid which is filled here. And there is a small opening at point M through which the fluid particles will get in and exert a pressure at point A on the liquid filled in the U-tube, which is the Pitot tube. And in this situation, the fluid particles which will enter into this Pitot tube from point M will come to rest. And the pressure of this gaseous media increases at the flow velocity decreases to zero as there is no continuous part to flow for the fluid. So due to increase in pressure, the level of liquid will go down, and on the other end where fluid is continuously flowing, the liquid level will move up. So in this situation, we can directly find out PA minus PV, that is the pressure difference at the two ends A as well as at end B. This can be written as H rho G, where rho is the density of this liquid, in which at the two ends liquid level differs by a distance H. And if the medium is not a gas, it is a liquid medium, then the same height level H of this liquid will also be used. So in this situation, we can say this PA minus PB can be written as H rho minus rho of liquid into G. This is the expression you use if flowing fluid is a liquid, because in case of liquids, we can never ignore gravity. But this is the situation we can use if flowing fluid is a gas, because in case of gaseous media, we can say the effect of gravity is negligible, so we won't consider any pressure difference due to the height H of this gaseous column. But in case of liquid, it has to be taken. Now, if we use Bernoulli's theorem at points A and B in the flowing fluid, so we can simply state if for flowing fluid we are applying the Bernoulli's theorem at this point B and at this point A. At A we can state that there is no kinetic energy, only there is some pressure, so we can write pressure at point A plus 0 is equals to, at point B we can take a pressure at B is PB plus the kinetic energy of flowing fluid can be written as half rho V square. V is the speed with which this fluid is flowing, and for gaseous media we can use it as Vg, or in general I can take this flow velocity to be V. So here if we substitute the value of PA minus PB from either of these relations, we are going to get the flow velocity of fluid in the pipeline. It is given by root of twice of PA minus PB by rho. This is the relation we use. So you can just keep this result in your mind, and PA minus PB we can take up either H rho G in case of gaseous media or H rho minus rho G in case of liquid media. The Pitot tube itself is a very useful tool which can be used for measurement of flow velocity of either gas or liquid. And in long back time, the Pitot tube was used to measure relative speed of aeroplanes also. In any surface of aeroplane, such a U-tube can be mounted, and if the plane is moving in a direction, the surrounding air will move relatively in opposite direction, and due to the flow of air, pressure difference is developed, and using this expression we can find out the flow velocity of air in the surrounding of plane relative to plane. So indirectly this velocity will be that of plane with respect to air. That is also a very good application of Pitot tube. And using Bernoulli's theorem only we can find out all the mathematical relations related to Pitot tube. So just be careful about this expression.